Hello again there, friends and fans. Raptor here, and welcome back to the channel for Flotsam. We're going to be building a city here on the high seas and see if we can survive in this, well, floating city builder survival game. Welcome back, everybody, and thank you very much for being here. If you haven't already and want to see more of this game, make sure you click or tap that like button, of course, to show your support to the channel, and glory to Raptoria down below in that comment section. Thanks for tuning in. This game is going to be quite fun. If you enjoyed when we played Buoyancy earlier, Flotsam essentially is a much more polished version of that, with a lot different style that I think I've come to love. So let's go ahead and jump right into it. I haven't played this game at all. I've only seen online photos, so we'll see what lies in store for our new city. So welcome back, everybody. Good to see you all here, and let's get started. Let's see what we have to do. Oh, well, that's it then. Garbage floods wiped away our village. Perhaps we should stop sticking to these useless rocks and go explore. Who needs land? The endless blue waves is all that we need. The flooded world is our oyster. Let's polish the plastic into beautiful pearls. If only we weren't out of fuel. All right, let's go ahead and name our city of Raptoria. Glory to Raptoria, if I could spell it. There we go. And let's start our adventure. So literally, this is my first time playing. This is beautiful, I must say. Awesome. Absolutely fantastic. Let's see what's around us. No islands or anything, it seems. There's a whale over here. We're going to have a whale of a time, I think, finding stuff over there. Oh, schools of fish. Yes, just like Buoyancy. Excellent. Looks like we got some tutorials over here, including camera controls, which are pretty basic, of course. Oh, we have a little island over here. Is this where we started? Oh, that's cool. Very, very cool. All right, let's see what this does. Ah, here we are, sailboat on the rocks. Some drifters tried making a town on that island. Bad idea. With all the garbage floods, the sailboat has been wrecked in the cliffs, so perhaps we can make use of it. Oh. Action requires a salvaging boat. Okay, we'll have to build a boat then, eventually, but that's something we can interact with later. Ah, there we are. There's our town center, also known as a town heart. That's cool. It actually has a crane on it for gathering materials. Looks like there's water that can be stored here as well, and it's kind of visual. That's cool. Let's take a look at resources. It looks like we have wood and plastic. We have canned food and water, and then wood and actual fuel for consumables. Interesting. Looks like we can find things on landmarks and make things from other whatnots. Okay, let's see. Buoy marker. Swimming markers allows drifters to make a swim. Has limited range. Boat marker and fishing markers. Okay, so that's where we can gather resources of different types on the water. And then the ability to salvage, scavenge, and rescue people. Okay. Well, we'll get into more of that later. I want to see the gameplay, though. The juicy, juicy gameplay. And I'm sure many of you will have some good ideas down below in the comment section, too. Ooh, place a salvage buoy only for swimming. Oh, I see. This is cool. This is like gathering in like Foundation or Dawn of Man. Excellent. So we can actually indicate where we want people to go swim. So until we get enough resources, there they go. So they go out and swim to gather them. Oh, that's so cool. I love that. So someone for now, do we know how many people are in our city? Maybe three? So it looks like we have three people out of zero capacity because we need to build some houses. That's cool. Love that. All right, let's see if we can get to building. I'm assuming down here's one of the building options. Researching? Ah, build right there. Perfect. We can start building things. Excellent. As soon as we have enough resources, of course. Let's see. Walkway. Very nice. Small storage yard. That's what we want right there. Small house. We just need to gather some wood. Okay, let's do some more gathering areas. This is obviously wood over here, so that's cool. I don't know if our people can be attacked by sharks or whatnot, but this is really our only way to gather things until we make a boat, so that's kind of cool. Let's go gather some more. Well, this seems to be a mix of wood and plastic. Let's go over there, too. Very good. All right, so we have three people. As far as I can tell, there's three people out swimming, so that's beautiful. What a gorgeous game. Love this. What a neat little city builder already. I love it. There are not enough houses to accommodate the drifters. All right, well, welcome to all the Raptorians, then. If you guys want to be in my city, too, by the way, say hi down below in the comment section. Hello. I might be able to name some. Oh, can we name people? Oh, if you want your name on one of the people, you got to go ahead and say hi down below. I'm gonna pick some special people come time to become citizens of Raptoria. This is early access as well, so if you don't like things about the game, it definitely could change. Building, let's see, town, food, water. Okay, yep, we've kind of got this all squared away. Drifter needs, of course, they need water and food and rest. Okay, that makes sense. Well, first and foremost, then we'll build houses because that's definitely one thing that they need. So when we get, let's see, six more wood, then we can do that. Looks like we have plenty of plastic. That's good. 15 out of 8. So I wonder if it's one house per person or if it's like one can hold 10. We'll see very soon. I love this. I love seeing them go out and swim and gather stuff. Looks like they actually have, like, snorkeling gear on, maybe? Or they're literally just swimming back with, like, a life jacket on so they can carry some more stuff. Very nice. Okay, what do we got for materials? So we got 40 food, we got 20 water. We now have 10, oh, I see, wet wood versus dry wood. So we actually need it to dry out. Okay, so we can't use it right away. Interesting. Metal scrap and plastic are also materials, too, that we can use. Is there any buildings that we can do to a small storage yard? Oh, we should probably put that down. Okay, let's put down a storage yard. Maybe that's where wood could be dried and stuff like that. Okay, hopefully that's constructed soon. Looks like we also have a distiller. Remove salt from seawater. Oh, actually, that should be called a... I think that should be called a desalination plant. But I guess distiller... Yeah, I guess that would... Yeah. Okay, that makes sense. Large amounts. So we can make water there. We also have boat parking. We also have the ability to put down a salvage boat and a fishing boat when we get enough materials. This is great. And then, of course, sails in order to move us around, like in buoyancy, when we had those motors. Very cool. And also... Yeah, we have... Wow, I love the fact that we can actually set out scavenging boats eventually. Very nice. Okay, storage depot is almost done. So it looks like people will just go and do whatever job we indicate. So essentially, I could just put down one of these markers and then just tell three people to work at it. But we could also move these markers too, like this one, because it's... Oh, we can shrink and enlarge. Is there a way to move, though? I guess we'll move it and we'll go... we'll just gather all the stuff from up here, since it seems close. Let's go ahead and put down a... Another swimming marker over here. Yeah, gather the rest of those materials. There's quite a bit, boys. Okay, now we finally have a storage yard. Fantastic. So I wonder how we dry that wood out now. How do we make dried wood? Let's check our research. Resources. There we are. How do we make dried materials? How do I make dried wood? Let's see. Some you can find. Some are floating in the water. Maybe we just need time to pass. I guess we'll find out in a little bit. I love this crane here, too. I wonder if boats can pull up and offload that way. That's so cool. What are you up to, sir? Look like, oh, he was filling up the town hall with rest of the resources. Okay, we have 25 wet wood, so we're not yet ready to build our houses. Let's see what else we can build in the meantime. This is a walkway. Allows drifters to walk around and attach buildings. We should probably build a few of those, huh? So that way we can eventually build off of our main town. Let's build it this way. There we are. Oh, you can do it this way. Cool. Shows how much plastic it requires. Let's go with 8 for now. Did I do that right? I think they're going to build a bridge to that point. So they're going to build a bridge made out of plastic there. Oh, there we go. Cool. Oh, it holds a very small amount. Okay, we better add some more of these storage units here. Let's put them around the main base just so they're easy to access for now. We can remove them later. Uh-oh, people are getting hungry. They should probably be able to eat at their homes. Let's make sure we've got that going on. I see no dried wood just yet. I'm not certain how to do that just yet. Ah, right there, a drying rack. That's where you dry the wood. Okay, cool. Now that we're building a bridge, this is the perfect spot for it. Perfect. I thought it maybe would dry out in the storage yard, but we actually need a drying rack for that. That is neat. I love that. Cool. All right, well, we need to make use of the wood right away. So hurry it up, boys, and get those down as soon as possible. And then we've got all of our salvaging going on over here. 3 and 4, good. Tells you how many supplies are left in the circle as well. I love this. Can't wait until we actually get to start rolling out on the high seas. And I'm glad we built more storage, too, because it looks like there's plenty of supply out there. Look at all this stuff. Oh, my goodness. Do you guys see that? That is some fish. That's beautiful. No, it's a giant whale. Look at that. Wonder if we can go whaling. Look at that gigantic whale. Amazing. Oh, look, we can click on things and push it underwater. Oh, I'm already entertained. Raptor. Oh, look at this awesome city builder. Also raptor. Wow, look at this barrel. Okay. There's our dryer going up. 2 of them. Beautiful. We got another person out salvaging. Wonderful. Beautiful, beautiful. And we can even speed up time, but I'm already liking this. Production limits. Okay. Oh, I see. We have a limit of certain materials, and we can tell them to only gather a certain amount. Well, I want everything for now. That makes sense. Also, farming in this game. Cool. Okay, we'll get to that a little bit later. They're giving me a lot of tips. Yes, indeed. But we need to do it one by one for now. Okay, no recipe selected. I would like you to dry wood, please. Thank you. Excellent. And then we'll do the same at the other drying rack. So now we've got wet wood that needs to be brought over and then turned into dry wood. So that's good. Wonder if it's automatic. It is on. Doesn't look like anybody needs to work it. Or maybe they do. Oh, yep, somebody's coming over. Oh, okay, so they just dump out stuff, and then there you go. Perfect. Excellent, now we can start building some homes. Okay, the hunger will be resolved because I'm assuming everyone can just go and eat and drink at their homes and sleep. So let's go ahead and make a check on that. Let's see, farms, workshops, basics. Let's see, drifter needs. Let's see, drifters can survive. Let's see, take care of hunger, thirst, drinking water in the town. Let's see, the drifter will drink some. Oh, okay, they need to do it at the house. When a better house, when food is available in the town, the drifter will eat some. So I'm assuming they go to the town heart for that, maybe? We'll see. Okay, wood is almost ready. Then we've got, looks like they can make 3 at a time. Yeah, so it looks like 3 wet wood can be turned into 3 dry wood at a time. So we'll get 6 going. So right now we've got 28 wood that can be turned into dry wood, wet wood into dry wood. And then 17 plastic, and then also some floating steel or something like that. So I'm not sure exactly where we could find that at. But I guess we'll look around here. Beautiful game. I love this. Love the concept. I love the idea of a floating city that can move around to gather resources rather than people moving around to gather the resources. I guess both are possible because we can send out salvage ships. That's really neat. That's one thing I wanted to see in Buoyancy as well, is the ability to build boats. But now we finally have it here. So what's the next thing we should build? Well, the first and foremost should be the houses. Then what is this here? Woodworking shed. Drifters can craft resources with wood, like rope and firewood. Ah, very cool. Then, of course, our distiller, which will boil seawater into fresh water, or salt water into fresh water. Allows the movement of the town. Excellent. We just need to find, it looks like, 4 metal parts. We need to make 4 rope at the woodworker, or at the workshop, and then 1... sail, which either we can find or maybe make out of materials eventually. Oh, perfect. Look at the wood. There it is. It's all dried. Excellent. We could start building our first homes. Homes for Raptorians. Excellent. All right. That looks like we need 6 in order to do that. So that should be enough as soon as he gathers the rest. Excellent. Good job, Raptoria. Looks like our, look at that. Our storage buildings are immediately full. That's cool. Very good. That means we've got, like, capacity to do more. So as somebody goes out to gather more materials, we've got plenty in storage to continue drying. Excellent work, guys. And we have our first home. Wow, that literally is a small house. I thought it was going to be a huge structure. Let's build it across from the drying racks. So that way they can come over here. And let's build some more of our bridge. So let's build it from here to... Oh, I see. This is how big we can build it. Okay, let's build it maybe 16 long. And we'll add some more drying racks, too. Very neat. I love this little island in the background. So gorgeous. Look at all the fish, dude. We got to get a fishing boat ASAP. Okay, so drying is taking place. We'll add some more dryers because wood is essentially important for sleeping and everything else. We've got a man there working on home building, so that's good. Looks like it's 1 home per 1 person, so we'll need to build a few more of these. So we got to get cracking. But at least everybody can take turns, I hope. Maybe if, you know, there's 5 people and... 4 homes, maybe, you know, they can take turns sleeping. When 4 of them are sleeping, 1 person can all be working. Maybe that, I don't know. Bum, bum, bum. Look at that, all that construction going on. Big O construction. Wow, that was, look at him hop through the water. That was great. Ah, look, he's delivering the materials needed for the construction of the bridge. And then somebody is actually working on the construction. And there goes the house. The house construction is almost completed too. Very good. All right, well, we got plenty of food, plenty of water, and there we go. That's the house? That literally is just a floating bed. That's not going to give anybody any sort of cover or anything. Is that done? That can't be done. There's no way that's done. It's done. A home for your drifters where they can rest. Oh, somebody's resting there? But it doesn't look like it. Okay, well, it looks like we only need 1 home then, I guess. Somebody's napping, but I can't really see if they are. Interesting. We have 3 people, but they all are working. He's building the bridge. He's standing here. Oh, I see. He's resting, even though he's in front of the building. I got it. Well, maybe we only need 1 then. All right. Well, with that said, let's go ahead and add some more storage yards. No, we don't need that. Let's go for drying racks, because that's going to be immensely important. There we go. And let's make sure we build these as close as possible to increase our efficiency now in use of space. Okay, let's also move some of these around. Let's see, we need to go out a little further from the town. Hopefully we don't get gobbled up by sharks. Let's see, 14 and 9, that's good. And then let's go a little further now to grab some of this stuff. More wood, please. More Ovaltine, please! Okay, let's go with that one. Perfect. Now we can make these bigger, too, but I guess I'll just leave them a little smaller there. We'll just make them this size. I don't want them too big. There we go. Because I want to kind of keep track of the materials that we're gathering. So far, so good. We only have wood and plastic as our two main materials. I don't see any floating steel around. I don't even know how we would get that. But anyway, everything's good so far. And our third drying rack is going up now, which will increase our capacity to make wood very quickly. All right, you go ahead and start that. All right, let's try getting some food now. Actually, water seems to be a bit more important. But in order to make that, we need 8 dried wood. So we just need a little bit more, and then we can start making some water. So I guess we'll put that near the main town. We'll attach it to the town heart. There we go. Let's build a bridge, though. All right, so maybe we'll make this section here for gathering our main resources, such as... if I build this, we won't be able to do it right away. That's okay. We'll get enough material shortly after they build the bridge. So my idea is to possibly do fishing and such here. We'll set up fishing boats and do that there, and then we'll have our water distiller over here. Very cool. All right, it's just a giant bottle, essentially, that boils water. Very neat. Okay, everything's going well. Swimmingly, in fact. Ha ha ha! Yes, thank you. I'll be here all week. Thank you, everybody. Appreciate that. Wonderful. Awesome. Absolutely, that's right. Sounds like I have my own talk show or something like that. Raptor Tonight, you know, like, tonight, I'm Raptor Tonight, you know. Okay, let's go ahead and see if we can do some more work. What should we do next? Well, we probably should do a mooring port, but first we need to have ourselves a woodworking shed, so we'll need those materials next. So food and water are okay for now, especially for just 3 people. And look at that, they got lots of drying rack stuff going on. Very nice. Okay, we should cut down on our gathering now and focus on... Actually, is there a way to make this just priority? I'd like them to still gather from those points, but I'd like more people to work. Doesn't look like there's a way. That's okay, we just need materials to come in, so let's speed up time a little bit, see how that works. Go, boys! I wonder if shark attacks can happen. That'd be interesting if we had to defend against sharks, or raiders, or pirates. Alright, the distiller is almost done, and yay! Fresh water is ready. Good, we just need to make fuel now, and I'm assuming we do that at the woodworking shed. So let's see. The nutritional value of the item is 1. All right, well, luckily we have stuff in storage, so we've got some time to wait. Now we just need everybody out gathering materials. Looks like a couple of our folks are tired. I don't blame you, same. But you guys just have to go here and sleep first. Oh, looks like one person's already in there. All right, one at a time then. Oh, there we go. Somebody's actually sleeping now. It's really hard to tell if somebody's actually in there. All right, let's build another one. That's pretty important. The ability to get rest. Napping is important. Remember that, kids. Especially when you get older. All right, 2 out of 6 plastic is ready for the woodworking shed. I think we'll put the woodworking shed maybe towards the end of this long pier here. I love this music. Listen to that. Very, very casual, very calm. All right, woodworking shed just requires 3 more plastic, and then we've got it. I don't think there's a way to move the city, is there? I can't right-click or anything like that. Okay. Oh, here we go. We can tell them to gather stuff or not. We can filter. All right, woodworking shed is ready, and no better way to put a woodworking shed than literally next to all the drying racks. I wonder if we could tell these guys to not store certain things here. Ah, cool, you can actually filter it too. So if you want to store all the wood next to the woodworking shed, you can do it that way so they don't have to walk as far, so that'll increase the efficiency. Okay, not too bad. We don't have too many supplies at the moment, so I think we're okay. All right, so now we should be able to make fuel, right? Yes, firewood can be made from the woodworking shed. So now we can start making water, so that's taken care of for now. And that man needs a nap, but I don't see any of the bed. Well, we'll start with 2. You need water, but you just need to drink. Okay, so let's see. Can we make fuel now? Let's make rope. Oh, it looks like we can make rope out of dry wood. So let's go ahead and make, like, 3 of that. Actually, let's make 5. Wait, was that 1 too many? Nope, that's 5. And then let's start making the rest into firewood. Okay, that should be good now. Speeding up time is pretty good. We'll go with medium speed now instead of normal. All right, then we can start making water. So let's try to make like 2 water. So is it 1 firewood for 1 water? Is that the transfer rate? Oh, look at 30 seconds requires 2 fuel to function. So that means, so that's 2 per 1. So 2 fuel equals 1 water. Oof, that's going to be it. That's a heavy oof, boys. What was that? Is that the whale? Quiet down, whale. You be quiet. We're working. Go take a nap. All right, workshops. Recipes can be auto-queued. Yep, I did see the auto-queue function, but I wanna make sure we're very limited on our supply use for now. Okay, so the fresh water should be made as soon as fuel is ready. And I think we're okay on supply for now. Seems like there's plenty of room in storage. Wow, our town is really small, but we've done a lot. There's a lot of good stuff going on here. Very nice. All right, I want to try a boat parking next. That's going to require one rope for us. So that's good. Oh, we got plenty of wood coming in too. So we got this now. We can finally start building some boats. Awesome. Okay, they're hungry and thirsty. Yep, there you go. All right, perfect. All right, water's really low, so good thing we went for that first. And then we can do fishing as soon as we've got that ready to go. Look at these guys over here working at the woodworking shop. That's hilarious. I love this cell shading art. It's really lovely. All right, another person's hungry. Got it. Oh, wow, you did everything? Good job. Oh, exports 4. You know, I'm just going to make all the water. Just anytime you can make water, go ahead and do it. It's going to be important. Dry wood 31. All right, let's make some more fuel, if you wouldn't mind. Go ahead and make more of that. And then looks like we need more wet wood in order to make dry wood. We need more people on our town now. And I'm not building another house just because it looks like our people can make it with as is. I guess let's enlarge more now. Well, that's a little too far outside the town limits. Okay. And we only have one area for salvage now? Okay. Oh, cool. It auto-removes it. If there's no more materials to be gathered, it seems like it removes it. That's good. Uh-oh, we're kind of out of materials, though. I don't know if I can move the town, can we? Not yet, anyway. We might be able to. I probably overlooked it. However, it's good that I just sit here and build the town first, like, instead of traveling for now. We should be able to do it once we make sails, like a steam sail. All right, we can finally put down a mooring point. Let's do that. Let's build that over... Let's see, we don't have much plastic left, so let's do it here temporarily. We can move it later. Then we can start building some boats, so we can actually go out and grab materials. Good. So there's still plenty of materials here. 7 wood, 5 plastic, and then over here, 5 plastic. Let's go ahead and enlarge that a little bit. 8 plastic now. Okay, we've almost gotten everything that we could possibly salvage in this area complete. We're about ready to make our sails, but for now, we can actually use salvage boats to go out and get grab materials and then come back to base, so that's fine. And then eventually, we'll have sails ready to go. This is perfect. Glory to Raptoria. Yes, thank you. Thank you, yes. This is awesome. I love this. This is great. All of our wet woods being turned into dry wood. Plastic's going great. We just need to find ourselves some metal scraps somewhere. All right, so the mooring point is being built. I wonder if we can't build... Oh, I bet we can't build this boat until we've got the salvaging boat ready. Or the mooring point. Okay, so we can't build a boat until we actually have stuff for that. We're almost out of water, boys. Oh, looks like they're making water. Perfect. Yeah, keep going. Actually, can I make it infinite? I don't know how to do that. There we are. All right, yeah. Infinitely make water. Anytime you can, go right for it. Finally, we can now do fishing and salvaging. Let's make ourselves a salvage boat. Is it only one parking spot? I think the salvaging boat is the right move. We still have plenty of food. I need some more materials, though, so we can get moving to other places. Hungry and thirsty. Same. Yeah, water's low. Roger that. Distiller's working away. That means we need to continuously make fuel then, so we better do that. Let's turn that on to auto fuel. Okay, so now this is bad news, though. This means one person is constantly working at the distiller, which looks awesome. Look at that steam shooting out. That's so cool. So we got one person constantly working at the distiller and one person constantly making fuel, which means we've only got one person who can go out and salvage now, but he should be able to do it on the salvaging boat. No problem. I love this game. I love this. This is just lovely. However, I don't know if the person can actually transport stuff back and forth. We'll see. Sir, could you come over and start working on the salvaging boat, please? Let's get rid of the rest of our markers and try to force them to focus solely on building a boat now. Just need a boat. Unless you're napping. Are you napping? Let's see. Sailboat on the rocks. Okay, so actually, we should be able to take a boat over there, maybe. Maybe that salvage boat has the ability to go over there. Because it says here, Salvage. We might actually have a boat to go over there and grab materials. Does it tell us what... Oh, there's a sail on it. Yes. Oh, and metal, too. We can finally start moving. Excellent. So we need to get that boat working. All right. So fresh water is constantly being made. I love clicking this. I don't even care. I like clicking things. Clickety-click. Click-clack-clickety. There we go. All right. We've still got plenty of wood to make fuel. Oh, there we go. Yes. Make that boat, baby. Yeah, get that distiller fired up. Make that water. Mmm. Tasty water. It's like Grandma used to make. Mmm. She had a wonderful recipe. She would take one part hydrogen and two parts oxygen. It was delicious. Just awesome. Whoa. Woodworking shed is completely full of materials. All right. If you, sir, could instead of work... All right, let's shut down... Yeah, there you go. Shut down this, and then that'll make him transport it now. Perfect. All right, the salvage boat is ready. All right, let's go salvage. Perfect. So now the salvage boat can go over to the island, grab some very important materials. So let's go over to the Isle Raptoria over there. And right now we're just going to make water for our journey. So you two just kind of... He's going to gather all the wood, firewood, and then he's going to drop it off at the distiller. Meanwhile, over here, somebody needs a nap. We got ourselves the sailboat on the rocks. Go, man, go! Grab that material. Sweet, he's going to grab that sail. Yes! That is so cool. Takes him a little bit of time to gather things. Neat. He also has rope and steel that he can bring back, so that's cool, too. All right, come on back, man. Load it up. You've earned yourselves a net. Oh, you got to... Oh, uh-oh. Don't die out there, sir. Oh, we're low on water. Luckily, we're still making more of it. I need more people. I need more people to join me. What is this? Oh, yeah, we completed that. All done, sir. Load it up there. You. We need to rename this person. So again, remember to say hi down below in the comments section. Let me know what your skills are too. I'm a 20. I've been truck driving for 36 years. Big fan, Raptor. Love your channel. You know, something like that. Let me know what skills you can offer me. If you can drive a truck, then you'd be perfect for hauling firewood back and forth. You'll just have to do it with your own two legs. All right, this man has earned his nap, his lunch, and his water. Good job, man. And it looks like we're making plenty. Good, now we can move. Now, how do we move exactly? We have a sail now. What is this? Yep, salvage. We did that. Now, is there more we can do? I guess we've salvaged everything we possibly could from it. We have metal scrap. He's offloading the rest of the stuff. That's what it is. So he's still putting it into storage, I guess. Good work. Good work, everybody. All right, let's slow down time now. Boats. Now, let's see what else we can do with boats. Now that we've done that, we can actually go out and get more materials now. So let's tell our boat to go out here and grab more. Yeah, grab all that wood. Now, here's what I want to do. We're going to plop down. We're plopping down for a while. Plop, plop, plop. We're going to plop down for a while, and we're going to gather a bunch of materials so we can make water. So first, now that we can basically make water infinitely so long as we have dry wood. So we'll have him go and grab that. Then we'll have somebody here making firewood, then we'll have somebody here making water. So that's good. Now we need somebody for food, and if we're going to find that somebody, that special somebody. Actually, the special somebody is anybody. Anybody who wants to join us. Do we find survivors? Do we find, you know, like another island full of people or something like that? Where do we find people? Well, we need to build another mooring point for another... Oh, it looks like only one per, huh? Oh, that sucks. I love the little parking icon. That's hilarious to me. All right, let's put one out here. And then I'd like to do a fishing boat now. So water, check. Fish, we're working on it. More people? I have no idea. We'll find out. Let's see here. Get an overview of all Drifter... Priorities, manage the maximum output of production. There are not enough houses to accommodate. That's fine about the accommodations because they're not going to all be tired at the same time, so I don't need to spend resources on that. That actually saves us resources. Like, he's tired, so he'll go nap, leaving one extra space. Look at the amount of supplies you have. Holy crap. There you go. That's the truck driver right there. That's that truck driver who's been driving trucks for 2 decades from Waukegan, Illinois. Excellent. Fantastic. Oh, this is awesome. I love this. All right, so now we just need to do more... I wonder... Metal must be a very special thing. That's how we move, Raptor. Oh, thank you. Thank you for telling me. Oh, my goodness. Okay, we can put this... We have, like, a sail point down. Let's actually put it over here. And we don't have enough plastic to really make it too long. How much material does this take? Oh, it doesn't take any plastic at all. Good. All right, we'll make this a little longer then. Glory to Raptoria. Let's make it another 8 long, and we're going to put our mooring point out there and get that done, and then we'll be able to move. Finally, we can go discover more things in the high seas. Doesn't he look like he has giant teeth? That actually, he looks scary. He looks like a zombie whale. That doesn't seem like a regular whale. We better watch out for him. All right. So it looks like there's tons of wood at the woodworking shed. Ah, well, good. Water supplies are starting to increase. Excellent. With limited people, we're only able to do a few things, but everybody is working hard, so our 3 survivors are doing great. I suppose that's me and Pinto and Steve. I have no idea. Okay, let's try another boat now. So, fishing boat, we need 12 plastic. So I guess we could have our salvager go out and find plastic now, prioritize that. Though we wanted to do wood because it's super important to start making that firewood for the... Oh, wonderful. We got 10 dried wood already. Good. All right, let's have everybody stay at base for a while. I'm actually going to cancel any other salvaging that we could possibly do. Oh, he actually gathered everything he could and brought it back. Dude, that's epic. Oh, wait, no, he didn't. I thought he got it all in one swoop. Wow, 114 wood? Oh, boy. Now the game's complexities are finally starting to show. I'm going to remove this, and I'm actually going to have him gather just the rest of the stuff here. I know it's going to be a small amount, but let's just grab everything that's here. It'll be a shorter trip the next time he goes, and that'll bring in some extra plastic for us before we start going any further. Or is it not worth the trip? Maybe it's not worth the trip anymore. Let's do this. We'll have the next salvage operation. Let's see if we can have him gather both. Can you... Oh, it won't let you put it where there's nothing, huh? I wanted to put it between and then expand, but it doesn't look like I can do that. I can only pick wood or... Okay. Well, I don't know if we can store this much plastic. We'll make it maybe a little larger. 65? That seems good. 65 plastic? That's more than we'd ever need. Perfect. Okay, so now the next 2 things to be built are the fishing boat and then finally the sail. Boys, we're about ready to move on the high seas. We just need that sail ready. Oh, good. The drying rack's full. Excellent. Or getting full. They're working on it. Excellent. And then the distiller just needs to do its thing. Alright, so food supplies are almost secure. Water's looking pretty good. Excellent. This part is done. We can now put down our sail, so let's do that. Perfect. Yes! The great floating city of Raptoria is almost ready. Excellent. And we're finally ready to leave this quote-unquote tutorial area. Wow, this is great. This game is... As you guys know, I'm pretty bad at games. Yeah, that's quite obvious, YouTuber! Thank you. But, this one is very, not easy, but just like, it flows very well. It floats very well. Look at how our city also bends, too. You can actually see parts of the city moving with the water. The city just doesn't move all at once. It actually moves in sections. You can see here that the sail is higher than the distillery. And then now the sail is going to be lower than the distillery because the wave's going to make its way over there. That's so cool. I love it. They've done well with this game. Very well. In fact, I can't wait to play it more. All right, sails need to be built. A fishing boat needs to be constructed. And water needs to be coming in like never before. Looks like they're working on it, though. At least we're not at zero. Food is going to be the next thing. Food and movement are the next 2 things we need to focus on. And in order to get that fishing boat, we are going to need 12 plastic, so we better... Actually, let's cancel the fishing boat operation, because that's going to take a long time. And let's just get some local... Is there anywhere we can get local... stuff. I just need 12 plastic, that's all. Is there anywhere nearby? Can this do 12 plastic? Let's try that. 12 plastic. No. Okay. So we'll have to go over here then. On our special operation after all. Love the music. Okay, so we are making water. The sail should be ready soon. Let's see if we can speed up time. All right, there we go. The workshop is working quickly. Look at him run. Look at him go. Very good. All right, so it looks like the rest of the materials are being delivered. Water is still a problem, though. They just need to drink, I guess. All right, a little bit of rest. A little bit of food. And How are we doing on this? Allows movement of the town. Excellent. Sails will allow us to move. Actually, we won't need to make these giant boat trips anymore. These luxurious boat cruises won't be needed anymore if we build that. Perfect. So we won't need the little job over here. So let's cancel that. We'll just move this town over here so we don't have to go as far to the actual main point, and that'll save us some time. All right, wood is getting low, but this is still giving us plenty of firewood. Excellent. We can move the town. Oh, and the music just picked up, too. Awesome. Oh, open map. Good. What? Oh, what? What? You can move to, like, a whole different... Oh, my. What? There's a map? What? This is amazing. We can actually move the city to a whole new... Villagers in an abandoned town? We can actually start building on the ocean? Or from the ocean to the... like, onto, like, an actual city? No way. It's going to take us a while to move, though, because we don't have any fuel. Oh, I can't believe this. This is awesome. All right, let's move to a whole new spot, then. Forget the whole regular plan. This is awesome. Oh, cool. Whoa, slow it down, boys. Whoa, where's the turbo speed coming from? Okay. Ah, now we have new objectives. I see. So now we need to rescue these people. We need these two people to join us, so we have a salvage boat for that. And then we can scavenge, too, from the shack town. That's excellent. All right, everybody, that is it for today's episode of Flotsam. I will see you all tomorrow for more. If you want to see more of Flotsam or Floating Sam or whatever, whatever, go ahead and make sure you click or tap that like button. That is awesome. So we'll make some more food. We'll get some people, recruits, and we'll do more in this wonderful, wonderful game. I'll see you all tomorrow for more. Thanks for being here. Take care. Have a great day. I'll see you soon. Bye.